You know, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could get you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically I'm saying either way we bout to slide. You can't let this one slide. 2,000 shorties wanna tie the knot, yeah. 200 shooters on my brother's block.
Hi, I'm Kira and I'm going to talk to you about the first day in high school. On my first day of high school, I met my best friend Lucy and we walked to the school together. When you arrive at the school, you'll see like two big gates and then a big crowd of people. When you follow them through, you'll be taken to two sets of double doors, and when you go through them, you'll be in the street. When you get to the street, you'll be called over to a big S1 assembly where the teachers will kind of go over how things work and timetables and stuff like that, and then you'll be put into your registration classes. One by one, the classes will be taken down to the pitch where you'll be shown where you're going to stand when there's a fire alarm and stuff like that, and then your guides will come and collect you and take you to the first class of the day where you'll meet your teacher and they'll introduce themselves and get to know you, and then the guide should pick you up about 10 minutes early so that you can get to your next class before everyone's rushing around trying to get to their next class. And the guides will be there for around 2 weeks after you start high school just to show you where things are and make sure you don't get lost and get to class to class. And you will roughly know your way around school by the time you leave. When I just started S1, I skipped four schools, so I was a bit late in and I didn't know where I was going. So I had to walk up to this S6 and I was like, could you help me find my class please? And they were like, yeah, sure. And they were dead nice about it and they helped me find it. So there's nothing really to worry about.
Hi everyone, my name is Kate Sinclair and I came from P700 to Calderglen High. Today I'm going to be talking about getting lost and finding your way around the school. If you get lost initially, do not worry because your teachers will understand. You will get a period table at the start of the year to help your way around the school because it will have the class number at the bottom of each class you have. You'll also get buddies for the first 7 days and you'll get out 5 minutes early for your first 7 days. Enjoy your time at Calderglen High and do not worry.
Hi, my name is Abigail and I'm going to be talking about the good differences between high school and primary school. The first one is you get to meet so many new people and make so many new friends. The second one is you get to move classes every 50 minutes. The third one is you get a different teacher for every subject. The fourth one is you get to do subjects that you don't really get to do in primary school, like home ec and technical.
I'm Megan and I'm in S4. I know coming up to high school can be really scary, so I'm going to be talking about my three favourite subjects and hopefully that'll make it a bit easier. Music, from the first day, I love music. It's really different to all the other subjects. You get to try a lot of new instruments and it was a completely new experience for me and I think most people. There's a lot less writing in first year music than in other subjects. And walking into the music department and hearing older pupils play, for me, made me really determined and want to play like them eventually. And hopefully one day I will get to their level. Music is hard. Learning to read music and learning music concepts is hard, but the more you do it and the more you practice, the easier it gets. And joining bands is a really great way to meet people and again practice that skill of reading music. When I started high school, maths was, I really did not like it. I wasn't good at it and it was not fun for me. But moving up into high school, I started to enjoy maths. The teachers do really take the time to explain things and, believe it or not, make it interesting. They find strengths in you that you didn't know you had, so even if you don't like maths, try it because you may end up liking it. Science in first year, you get a little bit of everything. You get physics, chemistry and biology. This will really help you when you move up to S3 and you have to pick your subjects. I find science in particular really interesting as I like learning how chemicals react together, how the body works, and even the speed of light. Doing experiments is really cool and exciting, and I think everyone will be excited for that. There's also a lot of really amazing hands-on stuff in science that you don't get in any other subject, and it's just really fun. Okay, so I hope this has made it a little bit easier moving up to high school, and remember, we've all been first years before, so.
Hi, I'm Hope, and I'm a house captain at Calderglen High School. One thing I love most at my school is the performing arts subjects. These subjects are drama, dance and music. In drama, you can use both your creative and communication skills when creating scenes with your classmates. Last year, our school did a very successful production of Our House. This year, we're working hard in the Adams family. I was part of this and found it very exciting and fun. Our drama department also has a drama club at lunchtime that everybody's welcome to join. In our music department, you can learn how to read music and develop new skills on instruments such as keyboard, tuba, percussion, drum kit and more. Both our junior band and choir are given the opportunity to perform at our Christmas show that we hold every year. The show is always amazing. Not only are they given this opportunity, but they're given lots of other opportunities throughout the year. There are also several music clubs that you can participate in at lunchtime. Dance Club of Glen has a lot to offer. Not only do we have Lunchtime Dance Club, but we also hold auditions for a competition team. This competition team gets to compete against other schools at the South Lancashire Dance Competition. I've been a part of the competition team since S1 and I'm so excited to audition again this year. Not only that, but we also have a dance showcase every year where we can show off all the styles we've been working on throughout the year, like commercial, contemporary, hip-hop and loads more. This is the perfect opportunity for you to show off your talents to your friends and family. I've also done a dance showcase since S1 and I find it very exciting. I love learning all the new dance styles and new choreography. I also love having the chance to perform. Our school's performing arts has a lot to offer and can't wait to see your talent.
Hi S1, my name's Holly and I'm a former second pupil at Calderglen and I'm going to be talking to you a wee bit about Gaelic. So on behalf of myself and the Modern Languages and Gaelic Department, I'd like to say a huge thank you and welcome, and I hope that you really enjoy your time at Calderglen. So I'm not sure if many of you are aware, but Calderglen is one of few schools in the full west of Scotland to offer Gaelic medium education, and so it's something that we're very proud of and something that makes us stand out among the rest of the schools in the vicinity. So first of all, to the Gaelic pupils who'll be coming up from our catchment primary school, Mount Cameron, Falcha Yuvilla, I can't even explain how many amazing opportunities you're going to have, and I hope that you're really looking forward to your new venture at high school. Miss McDonald will be there to support you all means of school, and she will be your registration teacher, so you can go to her for anything whatsoever. You'll be seeing her almost every single day of the week other than the day that you've got your reassembly. So I can't fault the department whatsoever. They're so supportive and their doors are always open, so you have nothing to worry about, and I hope that you really enjoy your time at Calderglen. You'll have so many new opportunities. You have the opportunity to join the Kayleigh band, so you'll be involved with the music department, and there'll also be filming opportunities with MG Films and Film G. So hope that you really, really, really get involved and you enjoy all of these new opportunities that are going to be put your way. And to the rest of the pupils coming up to Calderglen, don't worry. I know that not a lot of you have Gaelic already, but that doesn't mean that you'll not be involved in projects that the Gaelic department have helped to put in place. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about two of those and how they will impact you and how you'll be able to be involved through interdisciplinary opportunities. So first of all, for the past couple of years we've been working with the PE department to put plans together for our shinty pitch, so now that it's up and running, we are one of, again, few schools in the rest of Scotland who offer Camanach, so that's just shinty. So you will, through your broad general education, have an opportunity to try that out, so that's really exciting. And again, I was really involved in the PE department. I taught dance for 3 years at Calderglen, so I know that their doors are always open if you need anything or if you want to start up any clubs. And if you're working with two departments, it's very, very rewarding, so that's you involved in Gaelic indirectly, but it's still just as much a part of our department as it is the department. And also there was a project with a couple of S6 pupils a couple of years ago, and they put together the mezzanine project, so you will eventually get a chance to see that. It's in the library, and it's what we want to make it like a hub for the Gaelic community to come in and they can have their little meetings and stuff. But through technical and art, these are things that you'll be putting in place. The mezzanine is a no, it means finished, and we want everybody across the school to have to play a part in producing this lovely area for the Gaelic community. So with Gaelic funding, we
started building it, and then you will have the opportunity to expand on that. So these are all opportunities that will be within your reach, and although they're indirectly, you're not in a Gaelic classroom, these are all opportunities that Gaelic has offered your entire year group. So yeah, that's a wee bit about Gaelic, and hopefully you feel more involved in that side of the school, because I know that a lot of you will not be Gaelic speakers, but there's nothing stopping you from even wanting to start up a wee learners Gaelic club. I'm sure Miss McDonald and the Modern Languages department would love that. So I hope that you really enjoy your time at Calderglen, and best of luck.
Hi, I'm Sophie, I'm in fourth year and I'm a house captain at Calderglen. In this video I'm just going to be talking about what you can do at intervals and lunch. So you start your day and then you come in for two classes. After this you have your break, and then you tend to go down to the street, and then you can meet up with your friends and basically do what you want. And then after this you have two periods and you have your lunch. So in your lunch you come down to the street and then you can sit at tables with your friends. But you know, if that's not for you and you're not really one for just sitting and you want to do things like clubs, there's lots of things available for you. It's always really handy to pre-order your food as well. So this is in the morning where you go up and then you tell them what you would like for your lunch, and you pay for it in advance. It just basically guarantees that you're going to get it, because sometimes in the line, because there's so many people in the school obviously, and everyone loves the panini, so they kind of tend to run out a lot. There's snacks in the vending machines, like cookies, crisps, fruit bars, lots of things like that, where you just pay like 75p for a cookie, and then you can pay like £1 for a drink. There's lots of things available for you. There's also a line that you can go to, and this will provide you with like a hot thing, like a sausage roll if you're really hungry, or for instance like you've missed breakfast. So this is really great, you're never short for like options. I hope this video has answered maybe a couple of your questions, so thanks.
Hi, P7. I am Mr. Roger, the faculty head of PE in Health and Food Technology Department. I just want to say we're really looking forward to seeing you in August, and we're really sorry you can't be with us at the moment for your transition days. But to help ease any fears or concerns you've got, I'm going to give you a tour of the facilities so that you feel really comfortable coming up in August. So come on out to the PE department first of all. So when you arrive in the PE department, the first thing you'll see is this board. These are the members of staff who could potentially be your teacher next year. You'll have a look at the board, you'll see what class you're in, what working area you've got, and also the changing room that you'll be getting changed in. But come on, we'll go for a wee tour. We also have the t-shirts, which you'll all be wearing next year. And I understand information will be coming to you and your parents and carers in due process, how you can access the t-shirts.
So hello to our new first year, and to your families, a very special welcome from me, Mrs. White, head teacher. I hope that the three videos that we have made and the newsletters we've sent have helped you to start to look forward to your time at Calderglen High. You are a very important part of our planning just now, both in June and for August, and we are really looking forward to welcoming you into the Calderglen High school community and wider family. You will be very special new entrant to Calderglen this year, and we will do everything that we can to make you feel safe, secure and happy in your learning at Calderglen High. In the meantime, you and your families keep safe and well, and we look forward to seeing you in August and continuing to plan for you this June.